To kick off our research unit, we're going to talk a little bit about media. Consider for a minute how well you understand what media is. When you hear the word media, what do you think of? Could you explain it to someone? Media comes from Latin medium, meaning middle or center. And you've probably heard of a medium if you have any experience with art. You can convey art through many mediums. If you did a watercolor painting, the watercolors would be the medium you were using to express your art. In the same way, a medium is a tool of communication, such as a book, a billboard, the internet, anything that helps to channel information between people. So we can loosely define media as methods of communication intended to reach a wide audience of people. And therefore, this is a good place to start our research unit, because when you are doing research, you are going to be looking at different types of media. There are several different types of media sources. There's print media, generally printed with paper and ink. It's considered to be static, which means permanent or unchanging, because once a book, for example, has been printed on paper and ink, it is what it is. It's not changing. Electronic media is anything that requires electricity to broadcast the information, and this is often considered to be dynamic because it can be updated. It can be interactive. Some examples of print media are things like books, newspapers, magazines, pamphlets, brochures, mailings, posters, flyers, billboards, sales catalogs, photographs. Think about how many of these things you see on a daily basis. Electronic media includes things like internet, television, radio, film, audio or video recordings, multimedia presentations, email, or ebooks. Some other types of media you may have heard of before include mass media, which is either print or electronic media, which is created to reach large numbers of people. So you could have media that's directed at a small group, like a school newsletter, where the audience is, you know, the local community that attends or lives near the school. But mass media would be something that's directed perhaps nationwide. Its goal is to reach a large mass of people. News media refers to either print or electronic media, which has the purpose or the goal of informing people about what's going on. It focuses on delivering news, whether that is via TV, radio, internet, a paper newspaper, anything like that. And sometimes when we hear about the media, that's in reference to the news media. And lastly, you've probably heard of different platforms of social media. This is electronic media that allows people to post content and then interact with one another and the content that their friends post. So the word ubiquitous, you may or may not have heard of before. Ubiquitous means found everywhere. So think for a minute whether you believe it is true or false that media are ubiquitous in modern day life. Like all writing, the purpose of media can be to inform people and tell them about a particular topic or event or something going on. It can be to persuade people to do or believe something. It can be to entertain people. When we're analyzing media, part of being a smart consumer and thinking critically in your real life, right, is to be aware of certain factors that influence the media that surrounds you. So when we're looking at a type of media, we'll first notice the method of communication. And this is how the message will reach an audience. So for example, a newspaper would be one method of communication, but it could also be TV or radio or internet. Then we look at what specific genre it is, what category of text it falls into. So in a newspaper, you could look at an editorial, which is an opinion piece. You could also look at fact-based news articles, or you could look at advertisements. You could look at advice columns, which are opinion-based. You could look at comics, which are there to entertain. The reason we pay attention to the genre is because we expect different things from different types of text, right? You wouldn't read a comic, probably, to be informed about a particular topic. And similarly, you may not read a news article to be entertained unless it's a topic that you are interested in. They have different purposes, and therefore we read them differently. Then we consider the structure. So how is it presented and organized? Is it a headline followed by text? Is it audio clips? Is it video clips? Is it an image, perhaps with a caption? Is there a graph or a chart? One of the most important things when we're looking at media is that we can identify the central idea. What is the main message the author is hoping to convey? What's the overall meaning? Then we also look at who created it. We look at the author, the editor, the publisher, the organization that sponsored it. And the reason we look for who created this is because that gives us a sense of whether or not they might be biased. It gives us a sense of how familiar they are with the content and whether we can trust them as experts or not. And lastly, we look at the purpose of the text. Why did the creators of this media make it? What were they hoping that we would learn about or be persuaded to do? Or were they just trying to entertain, right? And by identifying the purpose, we get a better sense of what we can expect from it. If we were doing a research report, we would probably be looking primarily at things that inform, but that kind of depends on your topic. So as you look at media in your real life, I want you to consider, how is this media getting to you? How is it structured? What's the main idea? And who created it and why? So that you can be aware of the messages that are coming into your life.